Bretona Corner. Bretona Corner has always been an important transportation location. 100 years ago, it was a major railway stop on the CN line. Today, Highway 14 runs through it and serves as a major east-west trade route within the province of Alberta. The function of Bretona Corner has changed with the construction of the Anthony Henday, the yellow line, along the south edge of the city. Bretona Corner now serves to join traffic from the east of Edmonton and Short Park with the fast-growing areas along the south of Edmonton. Let's take a drive. With a brave, I free love of soul, come ride with me to the distant shore. We won't hesitate, break down the guarded gate. There's not much time left today. Life is a highway, I won't ride it. Okay, just kidding. This really is a drive. We are currently heading eastbound, soon to be northbound, on Highway 216, which is also the Anthony Henday Drive. That was good fun. I've got an idea. Let's turn around and head the other way. This is now driving on the Anthony Henday southbound. A misunderstanding once, but now we look in the eye. There's a third leg. That's Highway 14. We'll take that now. We are now on Highway 14, heading west, approaching Bretona Corner. This time, we'll exit to the right and head north on Highway 216, or the Anthony. Now, for a little about the modeling involved in this project. The picture you see before you is actually the entire area that was modeled, and the image measures between about 2 and 2.5 miles across, or just shy of 4 kilometers. Each of the kind of square blocks you see in the land divisions are actually quarter sections. They measure 1/2 mile by 1/2 mile, and that's how Alberta is laid out, much of it. The interchange here is a freeway level interchange, meaning that all movements are free, that there are no stop signs, that there are no yield signs beyond just merges. And the interchange opened in October 2008 with the completion of the Anthony Henday project, the southeast portion of that, which was a greenfield project that teed into the existing Highway 14. Among the complications in the design were the fact that there are railway tracks, the ones that give Bretona its name, running west of the junction, as well as the fact that the highways, at least Highway 14, is part of Alberta's high load corridor, or wide load corridor, requiring passage for vehicles up to 9 meters by 9 meters. And so you'll see a number of paths that provide a bypass for those vehicles of this junction. The modeling itself was done in VISSIM, version 5.1, and most of the parameters were left to their defaults, but freeway flow modeling was used, with free lane selection, and I used a speed distribution that had 35% of drivers going slower than 100, which is the posted speed limit, and 35% going faster than 110. I also broke that upper group, the people going over 110, with half of those going less than 130, and half going more. 130 is where the fines for speeding tickets quite go up. And based on my experience, that seems to line up. Traffic volumes were taken from Alberta Transportation's 2008 counts, and modeled as actually the AM peak hour, the AM rush hour, which proved to have higher volumes than the evening peak. Interesting points to watch is actually the merge area between Highway 216 northbound and where the on-ramp from Highway 214 tees in. Note that the merge area could probably function a little bit better with a little bit of tweaking to VISSIM. VISSIM does some funny things with lane selection and merging capabilities. You would not stop when you're running through a merge, but VISSIM likes to do that every so often. A few tweaks might improve the model to better reflect the on-the-ground reality. But, as noted here, the existing merge area functions fairly well. However, just for curiosity, I decided to double the volumes. The baseline for doubling is probably within 35 years. Alberta highways have been growing at a rate of up to 2% a year, kind of as a system-wide average for the last 50 years, and so that would put that doubling of volumes in about 35 years. But urban areas grow faster. There's a lot of high growth potential areas along the Anthony Henday, and so that doubling will probably occur sooner. And in any case, that 35 years is well within the design life of this interchange. It's interesting to watch the merge area under this doubled volumes. It seems to function well until one car gets stuck. And once one car gets stuck, Highway 14, the on-ramp very quickly backs up. And then fairly soon afterwards, the main line on 216 starts to back up. And so, although I think the merge area will continue to function well, it is a demonstration of the fact that the interchange is nearing capacity. And so one event, one incident could very quickly lead to major problems in traffic flow. Perhaps what will be necessitated is a third through lane, which is provided in the ultimate plans for the area. Thanks for watching. Many pleasant trails to you.